No.
So that is what no. Mr. Shinde no. was referring. And
absolutely
I
wrong.
One minute, Mr. Mitra. Mr. Mitra, please
absolutely
one minute.
Wrong.
Mr. Mitra, please one minute. Mr. Mitra, please one minute. And that is what our Honorable Home Minister was referring. Because he's a Home Minister, he must be having more authentic information. And on the basis of his own information, he has a full right to share with the nation and share with the media. That is what he did. You can have objection on that statement, but let
this
the inquiry be completed. Ask him to produce more proof, but you cannot deny the fact.
I will allow Sir Chandan Mitra the rebut, and I have a follow-up question for you after that. Chandan Mitra, there is, you know, I don't...
Yes, no,
he's the Home Minister. Was,
no, no, Home... That this morning's papers...
Yes. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Yes, have carried the list. When the Home Secretary has named 10 people who have nothing to do with RSS, nothing to do with BJP, who have been, even if some of them were members of the RSS at one point of time, they were all expelled from the RSS long ago. And the NIA
Sir, would
has
you admit,
officially said that there is no evidence whatsoever.
No, I have two questions. I have two
BJP
questions.
Your RSS activists, leave alone terror training camps.
No, I
the
have
Home Minister, he is a responsible person holding high office. He says BJP and RSS are running terror training camps. Please, you know, Arnab, please send your cameraman all over. Go to BJP officers, RSS officers, or anywhere in the country, and please find out for yourself whether we run terror camps or character building, nation building camps.
No, Chandan Mitra. Home Minister is not, we are talking in the context of negative politics. Home Minister is not completely shooting in the dark. The 10 people from Sunil Joshi, Sandeep Dange down to Ramji Kalsangra, they have had associations with the RSS. Now you can say those associations don't exist. 1 minute, sir. So he's not completely shooting in the dark. You know that. Now, however, my question is, on the one side, Sanjay Nirupam, your new leader talks of negative politics. The Home Minister says a political party is running terror camps to spread terrorism. That is exactly his comment on January 20th, 2013. In other words, you know that this is a clear attempt at saying a political party. It is one thing to talk about radicalization and another to be accusing a political party of running terror camps. Can the Home Minister of India say something like that? Is that negative politics?
No,
should Rahul Gandhi take a position on that?
You, Arnab, you are 100% correct. It is the job of Home Minister to create harmony in the nation.
Then I'm, yeah.
And by his act,
then?
By his action, he is trying his best. But at the same time, if there are some problems, if there are some organizations which are involved in the terror act, in the name of Hindu nationalism, their name has to be exposed. I don't see anything wrong.
No,
with
so
it.
Tomorrow. No,
so
no,
this
so,
is
to,
not
so, so tomorrow. So tomorrow you have a situation. I'm asking you a situation, Sanjay. Follow-up question to you. Tomorrow the BJP says we will hit the streets against Sushil Kumar Shinde's comment. My question to you is, how will Rahul Gandhi respond? Rahul Gandhi is now effectively the number two, and he's the vice president of the All India Congress Committee. My question is, you have admitted yourself as a Congress spokesperson that what Sushil Kumar Shinde may be factually incorrect and may have been wrong, may have been a case of overstepping and breaching the limits. My question to you is, the newly appointed leader,
yes,
of the BJP will take maximum political mileage. He says, I'll hit the streets. Sushma Swaraj will lead the protest tomorrow. The first challenge will be, how will Rahul Gandhi respond now? Will he come out and say, Home Minister was wrong? Will he distance himself and say, no, I don't want to talk about issues like this? What will Rahul Gandhi do now? First big test.
Arnab, how would Rahul Gandhi ji will react to this issue? It is completely hypothetical question from me. How can I decide?
How is it hypothetical? Rajnath Singh is going to milk it. Rajnath Singh is determined to take political mileage out of this. See, sir,
and
this is hard politics. Rajnath Singh is determined
Rahul
to
Gandhi
take political advantage out
vice
of this.
President of your party.
Yes,
it is up to Rajnath Singh or Sushma Swaraj or anybody in the BJP to play politics on any issue. And how we are going to react on that, it is our prerogative. We will decide at that time.
Yes, Chandan Mitra. Chandan Mitra is saying something to you.
You see, Arnab, no, I have a simple minor point here. As Sanjay Nirupam admits that the Home Minister has gone overboard, which is his tendency. We've had Home Ministers who keep going overboard in this Congress regime. But we have demanded, simple thing, that Ms. Sonia Gandhi and the Prime Minister must apologize for this terrible, terrible lapse on the part of Mr. Shinde, and Mr. Shinde should be removed from the cabinet. Now, if once he is wrong, which he is patently wrong, and has indulged in absolute negative politics, I would expect Mr. Rahul Gandhi, with all his kind of goody-goody comments about positive politics,
what do you mean goody-goody?
To ask Mr. Sushil Kumar Shinde to.
Now, what do you mean by goody-goody? Why are you stereotyping the politics? What do you mean by goody-goody?
Yeah, because he is not defining
what the response?
What is negative politics? What is positive politics? Yeah.
No, what do you mean
by... See, all good things he says. So, but there should be positive politics. Very good. Who disagrees? Who disagrees? Who can disagree? You tell me. But does it have any content? Does it have any meaning? When your Home Minister is running on the rampage and saying all kinds of things and deliberately provoking, and if tomorrow there's a large protest in the whole country, and then you will still not.
So why is there an indecision? No, my question is, Sanjay Nirupam. Sanjay Nirupam, let me tell you, there was a comment on saffron terror by P. Chidambaram once. And after that, you remember, your party general secretary, Janardhan Dwivedi, who today took Rahul Gandhi around at the Congress party headquarters, he clearly said that the controversy started, I'm quoting August 2010. You remember, Sanjay Nirupam. He said, yes. The controversy started because of a word. The agenda was not saffron. It was terrorism, and terrorism has no color. It is completely black in color. Whether you associate terrorism with saffron, red, green or white, it can never be connected with any color. Now, in August 2010, very quickly, when Chidambaram made that comment, the Congress came out and it completely dissociated itself from what Chidambaram said and corrected him. Tomorrow, Sushma Swaraj, Rajnath Singh and all BJP leaders are launching protests against what Shinde said. Why is it taking so long for Rahul Gandhi to come out, dissociate, distance, condemn what the Home Minister said?
Can I now?
Yes, please, Sanjay Nirupam.
It is not necessary on each and every issue our Vice President Rahul Gandhi should come out and give a statement on his behalf, on the behalf of party. Our spokesperson, chairperson of media committee and general secretary, Mr. Janardhan Dwivedi, has already spoken again that the terrorism doesn't have any color, terrorism doesn't have any religion. And we have clarified our position. Congress party has got this position for a long time.
No, they are asking.
But what Mr. Home Minister, one minute, please. But what Mr. Home Minister is saying, it is not baseless. It has a point. When he says that the people who are related to or connected to or associated to RSS are found involved in terror act in India, he has a right to share with the country.
So you are defending...
You cannot challenge that information. You cannot challenge that authority.
No, saffron terror? He used the phrase saffron terror?
I've already explained it, no, Arnav.
He said the saffron terror he was talking about. And he said there is report during the investigation that the BJP is conducting terror training camps to spread terrorism. This is the saffron terrorism I'm talking about. He has said
Arnab,
that.
I've already explained what is my party's position.
But you're saying it's not necessary for Rahul Gandhi to personally come out and talk about such issues.
That Yes, I mean it. I mean it.
Chandan Mitra.
It is not necessary for Rahul Gandhi to come out on each and every issue whenever BJP is a party which comes out with Morcha every day. And the CPM is go to a strike on every day. So these two parties are basically involved in that morcha and strike every day. And it is not possible for us to come out every day.
So irrespective of the agenda of the questions being asked, you're saying Rahul Gandhi need not come out and speak every day on such issues?
If the issues are really important and it is required that only Mr. Rahul Gandhi can address this issue, can explain this issue, he will come out.
I'm sure there are in the Congress party, there is enough talent so that Rahul Gandhi alone may not be the only person to speak about it. But issues such as Pakistan, issues such as Maoist terrorism, issues such as political corruption.
What is this, Arnav? On Pakistan issue, the whole government is speaking. Our Prime Minister is speaking, Home Minister is speaking, Defence Minister is speaking, External Affairs Minister is speaking. Whole party is talking about that issue. We are rather taking action. We are talking tough with Pakistan. Still, you want that only Rahul Gandhi should come out and speak on this issue. Yeah. I don't think it is so necessary.
Chandan Mitra, can I have a quick last rebut from you before I go into this break on the Rahul versus Rajnath debate?
Any specific question? I think I've already said that Mr. Rahul Gandhi must come out and condemn Mr. Sushil Kumar
Shinde. Sanjay Nirupam has said that it is not necessary for Rahul Gandhi. Not necessary for Rahul Gandhi to come out and speak on every single issue that the BJP may raise. In other words, the Congress party is not going to be reactive to your setting the agenda.
I would urge Mr. Rahul Gandhi to speak on some issue. We are yet to hear him talk on the economy. We are yet to hear him talk on society. We are yet to hear him talk on defense and security. We have not heard him talk on any issue. He talked that day in Jaipur about his mother coming into his room
Mr.
and crying. And so this is all right. 8 years he has not spoken on any issue. Let him speak on something at least. And Shinde would make a good beginning.
Mr. Mitra, you have made a good suggestion. We will forward this suggestion to Rahul ji.